Hang on, hang on.
Clap your hands! Clap your hands! Clap your hands!
Hey, City Kids, it's me, Pastor B. Coming at ya. Hope everyone is doing well. We have a worship service today prepared just for you. Today, you're going to hear a story about the people of God and their desire for a king. They wanted someone other than God to rule over them, and they got what they asked for, except it didn't turn out the way they wanted it to. But still, God had a plan. God did have a plan to send them a king, King Jesus, one day. And we're going to hear about King Jesus. We're going to hear how he loves us, how he forgives us of our sins, and how he's the kind of king that we can trust. And so enjoy today's worship service. We're going to sing together. You're going to hear an encouraging word. And I am going to see you on the other side of it. See you soon.
Hey, everybody.
Hi.
Welcome to City Kids Sing Song Sing Along. We are going to sing a song today that we've done before, Philippians 2:13. You guys know it?
Yep.
For it is God who works in you. For it is God who works in you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. I think you guys got it. Really good. All right, ready? You ready? Sing a song that we're not sure if we've done before. Yeah. It's the Lord's Prayer. She says we have. So it's the Lord's Prayer. It's based on the New City Catechism. So sing along with us.
What is the Lord's Prayer?
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Sing loud, here we go.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Guys, thanks for singing with us. time.
Bye.
Samuel was a judge over Israel. At this time, Israel had no king. But the leaders of Israel said, "We want a king like the nations around us." Samuel wasn't sure how to respond, so he prayed to God. God said, "Give them what they want, but warn them what it will be like to have an earthly king. A king could make their sons serve in the army. He could make their daughters work for him. Or he could take away their fields and servants." But the Israelites didn't care. "Give us a king," they said. God brought to Samuel a man named Saul. "You will be king," Samuel said. Saul was surprised. He was from the tribe of Benjamin, the smallest tribe in Israel. Samuel anointed Saul, and the Spirit of God was with Saul. When the time came for Samuel to introduce the Israelites to their new king, no one could find Saul. God said, "There he is, among the supplies."
Oh no!
The people ran to Saul. "Long live the king," they said. The Israelites thought Saul would be a good king, but Saul did not obey God. One day, Saul took an army to fight the Philistines, but the Philistines had more chariots, more horses, and more soldiers. Saul wanted to ask God for help. Maybe if he made an offering to God, they would win the battle. There was one problem. Only the priests, like Samuel, were allowed to give offerings to God. Saul waited, but Samuel did not come. Saul's soldiers started to leave, so Saul decided to make an offering to God himself. Then Samuel arrived. "You have disobeyed God," Samuel said. "You will not be king much longer. God is going to find someone obedient to be king." Sometime later, the Israelites won a battle against the Amalekites. God wanted Saul to destroy everything, but Saul only destroyed the things he didn't want. God told Samuel, "I regret that I made Saul king because he does not obey me." Samuel confronted Saul. "I did obey God," Saul argued. "I only saved the best animals to sacrifice to the Lord." Samuel asked, "Does God care more about obedience or sacrifices?" "You rejected his instruction, so God has rejected you as king." Saul admitted his sin and asked for forgiveness. Samuel said, "God has taken away your kingship today, and he will make someone else king." God intended for a heavenly king to rule over Israel, but the Israelites did not trust God's plan and wanted a king like the nations around them. God gave them a king, but Saul did not obey God. God had a plan to send his son, Jesus. King Jesus trusted and obeyed God perfectly and died so sinners could be forgiven and accepted.
Good morning, City Kids. It's Miss Ashley again here with you this morning. I'm so excited to see you guys. Gosh, I cannot believe that the Israelites wanted a king to rule over them. Didn't they know that they had God with them? He's like the best king. But I guess they just didn't really want to hear what he had to say. They wanted an earthly king to rule over them, which in some ways just doesn't make any sense to me. But we do have a lot of earthly rulers in charge of us these days, whether it's in our city, in our state, in our country, even worldly leaders that we listen to, which got me thinking, what does God say about that? If the Israelites were rejecting him as king and asking for a human in his place, what does that mean for us today? Who has authority over us? Is it only God? Is it God and our leaders? Is it only our leaders? Gosh, that's like a lot of questions. So I thought today I'd actually hand it off to a guy who helps make all those really cool animated videos that we watch every week and hear what he has to say, because he's got an interesting perspective. So I'm going to hand it off to him. But before I do, just remember, guys, you have until July 31st to complete those summer quarantine quest challenges. And this week, especially on Wednesday, July 29th, we're going to hold a special Zoom session. So if you're behind on any of those challenges, you can join us on that Zoom session. It's a video call, and we're going to help you earn at least 5 challenges if you go to that video conference. So pay attention. We'll post the link for that later, but just wanted you guys to be aware. So let's go check out what our friend has to say about earthly leaders. All right. Bye, guys. I'll see you next Sunday.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Elijah from Bardstown, Kentucky asks,
if Jesus is our true king, does that mean we don't have to listen to earthly leaders?
You know, Elijah, I'm glad you recognize that Jesus is our true king. That's what we saw today in the Bible story when the Israelites wanted an earthly king, and that was their way of rejecting God as their king. And so it's important that we understand that God is ultimately our king, that he's given us Jesus, and he is our true leader. But God has also given us earthly leaders, earthly rulers. We have governments, we have police, we have teachers and so forth, others in authority over us. And all of these people are in authority based on God giving them authority. And so yes, God wants us to respect them. He wants us to obey our leaders. That's important because when we do that, we're showing that we obey and trust God who has given them to us. But there's one little wrinkle we have to be aware of, that we are to obey our earthly leaders as long as they obey God. There may be times when an earthly leader would tell us to do something that is disobeying God. And again, for us, that is very, very rare. But it can happen. And in a time like that, what we need to do is we need to pray about this first and make sure we are understanding the situation right. But then we are to choose to obey God rather than an earthly leader if, again, listen to this, if and only if that earthly leader tells us to do something that is not in obedience to God. So obey our leaders unless they tell us to do something that is disobeying God. And again, that's going to be rare if you ever experience that. So here's a question back for you. How does God being in control of our leaders help you respect them and obey them more?
Hey, City Kids, hope you enjoyed that worship service. It was so great to worship with you this morning. I hope that you have the most amazing week this week. I want you to remember as you go about this week that the peace and the love of Jesus Christ is yours this week. May it go before you, and I'll see you real soon.
Clap your hands!